Hi, my name is Beth Hiley, here for Board Game Geek TV at Gen Con 2013. I'm sitting down with the ever delightful Tom Vassell.
It's my first time on camera, so I'm a little nervous.
Oh, okay. It's all right. It's very easy. And actually, Whitney just slid the box over because you are here to talk about your game, which is Nothing Personal, which is going to be released by Game Salute.
It is released.
It's out. It is released.
The Kickstarter's out.
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah, it's here at the convention. It's a game designed not just by me, but by Steve Avery, but he left like an hour ago on his way back to Atlanta.
Which means you can totally take credit. No, it's okay.
I'm the co-designer. Steve's the designer. This is a game. It's a Euro game where you stab and hit each other and use special abilities. Trying to get the most points or respect. We all want respect. Some of us don't get any of it. Others get some. But now you can have your own mafia family. Like, I'm sure you'd pick that one.
Della Rosa.
I'll pick the shoot fast, speak last. And each of these comes with a bunch of tokens of that type. So we refuse to use cubes in Dice Tower Designs. So we're using these little tokens here. And as the game progresses, what you're going to be doing is you're going to be playing these influence cards, which will let you put influence on different people. For example, this lets me put one on a gambler.
Okay, so I'm finding
green gambler. Right, so Snack Daddy De Ahusio, you put one on him. Or this one lets me put three on a thug.
Okay.
So I put three on this guy. Or I could put three up here because he has all the different symbols.
Mm-hmm.
Now, these cards will let you do other things. Like, for example, this lets me draw two influence cards, give one to another player. So I could give one to you, but you'd have to pay me.
Oh.
Or threaten me. Or plead. And nothing in this game is binding. So let's say there's three of us playing. You, me, and we'll pick a random person called Eric. So Eric is here, and he says, Tom, if you give me one of those two cards, I'll give you $5. I say, no problem. He gives me $5, I give you the card.
Oh.
Now that's totally legal and recommend it. It will cause a little bit of friction in your group until you realize that you do this for every moment of the whole entire game.
Because nothing's personal.
Well, for me it's personal, but for most people it's not. Whoever has the most influence on somebody is going to control that person, and that will give them a certain number of respect and a certain number of money. Money's used for all sorts of things. Also, each of these characters will have a special ability that they can do. For example, this gentleman here can pay $10 to kill another gangster. You roll dice and you miss or you hit them.
Mm-hmm.
They get killed. They're sleeping with the fishes.
Aww.
And then other gangsters can move up into their spots. New gangsters come on the board. It's like El Grande, except you can kill the areas. If there's a tie when it comes to respect, then whoever has this capo ring, which actually comes in the game, look at that, it's better than mine. And if you have this ring by controlling the capo, you break the tie. You can do it any way you want, if they pay you off, etc. And so there's lots, but what's really cool, one of the neat mechanics Steve came up with this one is, you know how it is in an area control game when someone has, you know, this much area, why should I even try to take over? In this game, if there is at the end of each round, enough influence on somebody, depending on the number of players, then they go to prison because they've attracted too much attention from the police. And then somebody else, now Eric Summer, is now the capo. Somewhat like real life.
I hadn't realized it. I had forgotten
Eric,
that.
The voice.
The voice, yes. Your likeness is in here somewhere, yes?
Possibly. Maybe. Possibly. We don't want to make people not buy the game. I'm right there.
I'm right there.
Tom the Insane, Vasilini. Now, we have different spots here for prison and death because unlike the Marvel Universe, in this game when you die, you stay dead. But you can come back from prison. There's all sorts of cool effects that you can play. So you're going to do this for 5 rounds, and at the end of 5 rounds, whoever has the most respect wins. There's all sorts of cool abilities, though. You can pay money to force a die to be re-rolled.
Mm-hmm.
There's special abilities. Like, for example, I have -1 money. We tried to make it realistic. there's famous designers in the game. We have a designer deck of all different designers, Rob Davio, Richard Launius, different people, and every game will be different because the gangster spread is different. But it's a very heavy negotiation game. We said that this is the opposite of a cooperative game. So if you like getting along with the other people, don't play this one.
How many does this play?
3 to 5. I didn't want to lie like a lot of games do and say it plays well with 2. And I didn't want to lie and say that it plays well with 6 because that would take too long. 3 games, not so long. A 5-player game is pretty good. It's longer, but it depends on the interaction between the players.
And if you were going to throw a time amount out for?
90 minutes to 2 hours. 2 hours, well, I hate when companies lie about that too. Probably 2 hours.
All right,
probably
all right, we'll
2 hours.
Round up.
And I mean, look at the stuff that comes with this. You get these metal coins. There's no paper money. Another rule for a Dice Tower Designs game. These are some of the thickest tiles I've ever seen in the game.
Yeah, I think that's 3mm cardboard.
Gangster meeples, custom dice, some of the best artwork I've ever seen in a game.
Yeah.
I'm very happy with it. But despite the superb production, I think it's a lot of fun too. Look at that, 7 minutes. That's
seven
better
minutes
than other companies.
Tom, thank you so much for showing us. Nothing personal.
We're going to show a live game of this eventually on maybe another review network.
Maybe.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
You were talking on your podcast about if a game would change if the characters were less abstract and you actually knew them. Do you feel bad about killing yourself or killing Eric in this game?
Actually, I feel really good when I kill somebody that I know because I think it's funny. No, my character has a special ability. He can kill somebody for free.
Okay.
But then he dies also.
Okay.
I tried to set it up so my character died in almost every game. It's therapeutic for my wife to play it then.
Okay.
John's question was, did Tom find it disturbing and or satisfying to be able to kill off people that he knows personally, including himself? So.
Now, I wouldn't put my daughters in the game, I guess.
That might get you in
trouble. But I mean, I think most people find it hilarious to see themselves die.
Oh, thanks for coming, Tom.
My pleasure. I really enjoyed it. There's a lot more I didn't mention. That's just a quick condensation
of
the rules.
Oh, hey, that's what people like. So, yeah, as you well know.
You come to Gen Con next year, you really should be sitting there watching this. You should be here.